He's almost 6 foot four. That's right, it's Vernon Kay.
Family Fortune, the show where we ask 100 people a range of everyday questions. This week, I've been in the ITV bar. No surprise. I know what you're thinking. But I asked 100 women the same question, and every single one of them slapped me in the face. The aim of the game is very simple. Two families have got to guess the top answers to the surveys we've carried out. Get them right, and they could win up to £30,000 for a charity of their choice. Get them wrong, and they'll hear this. I love that noise. Now, tonight's families are filled with excitement, hope and trepidation. In short, they're absolutely full of it. Now, are you ready to meet them, ladies and gentlemen?
Yes!
See if you can guess which bird rules the roost in this house.
Hi, Vernon. I'm her mum. Come on in.
Hi, I'm Peter Estep.
Hi, I'm Nina, her sister. When she was a child, she'd keep us entertained with her impressions of Michael Jackson. It's supposed to me.
In 2007, she braved the jungle with a bunch of other celebrities, even though she's petrified of snakes. Woo!
Hi, I'm Rob. Oh, forgot it. Sorry. Hi, I'm Rob. I'm her brother-in-law. And every year she brings out a new sexy calendar. Gotta do a poke.
It was nice having you over, Vernon.
Can't wait to see you on the hot tin.
Please welcome Gemma Atkinson! Hello, Gemma, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
You recognise you with your clothes on.
Oh, no, it's not looking.
Gemma, where have you brought your family from?
From Bury and Haslingdon.
All right, Gemma, please introduce me to your family.
This is my mum, Sandra.
Hi, Sandra.
Hi, Vernon.
My stepdad, Peter.
Hi, Peter.
Hi, Vernon.
My sister, Nina.
Hi, Nina.
Hi, Vernon.
And my brother-in-law, Rob.
Hi, Rob.
Hi, Vernon.
Now, Rob, have you learnt to poke yet?
Oh, I'm crying.
Still going, Rob. Just do it one more go. Come on. Oh, there you go. There you are, classic. Gemma, which charity you play for tonight?
It's Penderbury Children's Hospital. They treated my nephew, Tyler, when he had meningitis, so...
Good. Good luck, the Atkinsons tonight. Give them a big round of applause. Now then, you need two families to play Family Fortune, so see if you can guess who's the leader of this rowdy rabble.
Hi, I'm Enid, his mum.
I'm Paul, his dad.
Come in, we'll tell you all about him.
Gemma, his oldest friend, and as a child he used to do a lot of theatre, including playing a hobbit in The Hobbit.
Precious. Oh, precious.
In 2007 he was named Best Actor for his performances in Coronation Street. I dedicate this award to all of my fans. You can see how he gets performances off, can't you? It's not me.
He's a huge fan of Shirley Bassey, and he knows every song by heart.
Goldfinger, he's man, the man with the Midas touch.
Hope you've enjoyed your visit, Vernon.
See you soon.
Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're in for a Northern Rumble tonight. Please welcome, from Coronation Street, Anthony Cotton! Hi, Anthony.
Hiya.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much for having me.
Not yet. Where have you brought your family from?
We've
you've come from Bury. Well, from Manchester.
Right, OK. Please, Anthony, introduce me to your family.
First of all, we've got my mum, Enid.
Hi, Enid.
Hello, Vernon.
My dad, Paul.
Hi, Paul.
Hi, Vernon.
This is my sister-in-law, the sister I never wanted. My sister-in-law, Michaela.
Hi, Michaela.
Hi, Vernon.
And my oldest best friend, Gemma.
Hi, Gemma.
Hi, Vernon.
Now, Anthony, tonight's all about charity. What charity are you playing for?
I'm playing for the fabulous Terence Higgins Trust.
Good luck. Good
Thank
luck.
Thank you very much.
Give them a big round of applause. The Cottons! Right, we've got our families and they're so switched on they could cause global warming. Gemma and Anthony, come and join me as we play Family Fortunes. Anthony, Gemma, Anthony, good luck. It's single money, every point's worth a pound. Surveyed 100 people, we're looking for the top six answers. Name someone you would trust to keep a secret. Anthony.
Your mum.
Your mum. You're saying your mum. Our survey says... Yes, your mum. It's up there. It's only the third most popular answer. Gemma, we're still looking for the top answer. What do you think?
Your best friend.
Good luck. You're saying your best friend. Our survey says... Yes. I'm going to play. All right, as we go back to your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal. Sandra, name someone you would trust to keep a secret.
My sister.
Your sister. Well, let's see if it's up there. Good luck. Our survey says... It's not her. Unlucky, Sandra. Peter, what do you think?
Your mum. Oh, it's up.
It's gone that Peter. Peter, are you in the room? You're waiting for your dad. All right, Peter's saying his dad. Our survey says... It's not her. You've got one life left. Start conferring, Cotton family, because we might come over to you. You might get the chance to steal. Nina, what do you think?
Husband.
Your husband. Ooh. The pouter. You're saying your partner. Our survey says... Yes, well done. Get your family in the game. Now, Rob, over to you. What do you think?
A stranger.
Yeah, mate. You want to know a secret? You're saying a stranger. Our survey says... Oh, it's not them. What a shock. Tell me what you think.
A priest.
A priest. Michaela?
Doctor.
Doctor. Paul? Not Dr. Paul, but Paul.
A work colleague.
A work colleague. Enid?
I was going to say a vicar. Is that different to a
vicar,
priest?
A vicar, priest. Different religion, but we'll have it on, sir.
Doctor or teacher? I'm going to say a teacher. A teacher, do you not think?
Doctor.
A teacher. Doctor. 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 A doctor. A doctor.
You're saying finally a doctor. For the steal from the Atkinsons, our survey says... It's a... Well done. Well done, well played. All right, let's take a look at those missing answers. The sixth most popular answer was... A dog. A dog. A dog. Fourth most popular answer was... Vicar or priest. Well done, you said that. Congratulations. Now then, at the end of the first round, the Atkinsons have yet to score. But with 70 points, it's the Cottons! Now, don't worry, Atkinson family, there's no losers on this show. Apart from you, obviously. Join us after the break with more Family Fortunes. Welcome back to Family Fortunes. It's the Atkinson family versus the Cotton family. It's the man who makes underwear versus the girl who models it. Unfortunately, not tonight. Never mind. So, the Atkinsons have yet to score, but in the lead with 70 points, it's the Cottons. Sandra and Enid, come and join me. Let's play more Family Fortunes. Come on, Enid. Sandra, this is Enid. Enid, this is Sandra.
Hiya.
Shake hands. You did it wrong. Let's do that. Right, good luck, ladies. It's still single money, every point's worth a pound. One on by your buzzer, one on behind your back. Good, we're ready to go. Here goes. Name something you might do to make your partner smile? Sandra.
Take the clothes off.
Take your clothes off, you started with your bangle. My survey says... it's there, give him a flash. Sandra, unfortunately, that's not the top answer. I'm still looking for it. Enid, what do you think?
When I sing.
It makes your partner smile when you sing.
When I sing.
When you sing. You're saying when you sing, it makes your partner smile, our survey says. It's not there, John. Play off past Sandra. We're going to play it. OK, so Enid, go back to your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal. Sandra, go back. Peter, what do you think? Name something you might do to make your partner smile.
Tickle him.
Tickle them.
Yeah.
Our survey says... yes, well done. Second most popular answer. Nina.
Buying presents.
You're saying buying presents. Our survey says... yes, fourth most popular answer. We've got all three lives left. We're looking for three more answers. What do you think, Rob?
Weekend away.
Here we go. A weekend away. Oh, unlucky, Rob. Unlucky. Gemma, what do you think?
Tell them you love them.
Make them smile.
Hopefully it does.
You're saying tell them you love them. Our survey says... it's not there. Unlucky, Gemma. Sandra, you've got one life left. We need three answers. Cotton family, get ready. You might get the chance to steal. Good luck, Sandra. What do you think? Name something you might do to make your partner smile.
Send them flowers.
If it's up there, you're still on the board. You're still in control of the board. If it's not, Cotton's will come in over to you. Good luck. You're saying send them flowers. Our survey says... it's not there. Gemma, what do you think?
Know what I want to say, but...
what do you want to say?
Make love.
Maybe
not. I was going to say you love them, but we've had that.
Yeah. Paul?
Tell them a joke.
Tell them a joke. Enid?
Say I want a divorce.
Anthony, what do you think? You can have one of them or one of your own.
Thank you for that brilliant answer, Mum. I think we'd go with my dad. Tell them a joke.
Tell them a joke. If it makes your partner smile, you've stolen the board one more time from the Atkinson family. Good luck, you're saying tell them a joke. Our survey says... yes! Well done! Well, Anthony. Let's take a look at all these answers. The sixth most popular answer was... smile. Name something you do to make your partner smile. Smile.
Oh, because you smile back.
Smile back. The third most popular answer was... kiss them! Right, at the end of round three, the Atkinsons have yet to score, but in the lead with 107, it's the Cottons. It's time to quadruple the stress, triple the tension and double the money. Peter and Paul, come and join me as we play Double Money. Just walk away. Just walk away. Walk away. And you walk away. Come back, Peter! Come back, Paul! Serious game, this. All right, it's double money. Every prize with twice the price. Name something. Oh. If you answered this one, and you sat at home, God only help us with what answers you gave us. Name something you can do with a banana.
Oh, eat it.
Eat it. Let's have a look. Our survey says... yes!
We're going to play.
All right, Peter, go back to your family, start conferring. Now, Michaela, before we come to you, Anthony, you've always been a performer, haven't you?
I started when I was really young, yeah, when I was about five. I started dancing.
Yeah.
Why?
Take a look at this. Anthony was a rabbit.
But I want it to be Ali.
All right. Michaela, what do you think? Something you can do with a banana?
Make people slip on it.
Make people slip on it. Our survey says... It's there! Yes, Robin McKayla! Right, Gemma. Here's something you can do with a banana.
All I can think of is wear it. I keep seeing it on the edge.
Hang on, hang on. Did you just say wear it? You're saying wear it. Our survey says it's not there.
No.
Can you believe it? I'll say, what do you think? Something you might do with a banana.
Peel it.
Oh, yeah.
Peel it.
Let's have a look. You're saying peel it. Our survey says yes. Second most popular answer. You've got two lives left. We're looking for two answers. Atkinson family, get ready. You might get the chance to steal. Enid, what do you think?
When you have it with ice cream, it's called a banana split.
A banana split. Mm. Our survey says. Yeah! Well done! We've got two lives left. We're doing very good. Paul, what do you think?
Make a smoothie out of it.
Make a smoothie out of it.
I'm surprised my father knows what a smoothie is.
You're saying the smoothie, our survey says. Oh, unlucky. Right, Michaela, pressure's on you. You've got one life left. We're looking for one answer. What do you think it is?
Use it in a cocktail. Has, but, oh, no,
I just may as well start over here. Good luck. All right, keep confirming. You're saying make a cocktail out of it for the full board. A clean sweep. Michaela's saying make a cocktail. Our survey says it's not there. Rob, what do you think?
Fritter.
A fritter. Nina?
Chop it.
Chop it. Peter?
Put it on a sandwich.
Put it on a sandwich. Sandra?
Give it a monkey.
Brilliant. I love you, Sandra. What do you think, Gemma? You can have one of them or one of your own.
I'm going to go with the fritters.
You're going to go fritters?
Banana
for the
fritters.
Steal. From the Cotton family. Gemma is going fritters. Good luck. Our survey says... it's not there! Unlucky. Unlucky, it's not there. Come back to you. Well, no, we're not coming back to you. It's finished. We're just going to get the missing answer, but you won the points. The fifth most popular answer. Something you'd do with a banana is... At the end of the first double money round, the Atkinsons have yet to score. Oh. But in the lead with 259, it's the Cottons. Let's welcome our four family members, Nina and Michaela. Come and join me for the final round of Double Money. Nina, Michaela, Michaela, Nina. Good luck. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top four answers. Still double money. Every point's worth twice the prize. Name another word for money. Michaela.
Currency.
Excuse me, sir. Just lend me some currency. Right, you're saying... don't talk anymore. You're saying currency, our survey says... it's not there! Nina, what do you think?
Cash.
Cash, our survey says... yes, well done. Do you want to play or pass, Nina? Well, OK. So I can throw it in cotton for me, you might get the chance to steal. Rob, what do you think? Another word for money?
Dosh.
Dosh. You're saying dosh, our survey says... yeah! Now, as you know, I'm from the 40s, that noise means you've won a prize, Rob. Take a look and a pout at this.
Rob, get a load of this. American football is coming to London later this year. That's right, the New Orleans Saints are going to be playing at Wembley on the 26th of October. And to celebrate this monumental event, you're going to a game yourself, but not the away game here in the UK. No, you're off to enjoy the Friday night lights in Louisiana, USA. That's right, you've won a luxury trip to see the Saints in their hometown. And we'll even throw in $1,000 spending money. Yeah! Touchdown!
Well done, Rob. Congratulations. Gemma, name another word for money.
Dough.
Dough. Our survey says... it's there. Well done. We've got some points here, Sandra. We've got three lives left. We're looking for one more answer. What do you think? Name another word for money.
Spondoolies.
Spondoolies. You're saying spondoolies. For the clean sweep, for the full board. You're saying spondoolies. Our survey says... ooh. Peter, what do you think?
Bread.
Bread. Bread. All right, good luck. You're saying bread. For the full board, our survey says... Oh, come on. Nina, what do you think?
Pennies.
All right, you're saying pennies. Cotton family, get ready. You might get the chance to steal if it's not there because this is your last life. Good luck. You're saying pennies. For the full board, our survey says... Oh, man alive. Gemma, what do you think?
Wad.
Wad. Michaela?
Wonga.
Wonga. Paul?
Folders.
Folders. Enid?
I say Wonga.
Wonga, yeah. Anthony, can I have one of them or one of your own?
I think I'm going to have to go with Wonga. I don't know why. Does that sound ridiculous? Wonga.
You're going to
go... say Wonga? Please let it be
you
right.
You can say Wonga. For your sake, Atkinsons, I hope it's not up there.
So do we.
Do you know what I mean? You can get some points on the board. Really embarrassing going home without. You're saying Wonga.
Wonga.
Our survey says, for the steal... Oh! Right, at the end of the main game, the Atkinson family scored nil points. But the winners with 415 are the Cotton family. Now, Anthony, you're going to be playing in our big money final, so just bear with me one second. We'll come to you in just a moment. But unfortunately, we've got to say goodbye to the Atkinson family. Have you enjoyed yourselves?
Yes, yes. Thank
you. That surprises me because you scored no points.
I know. I know.
Well, don't worry, I'll tell you what we'll do. Well, what we're supposed to do is times it by 10. But we'll give you £1,000 for your charity anyway.
Oh, thank you.
So give the big round of applause to the Atkinson family. Just Rob, you take some that trip to Louisiana, see the New Orleans stage, have a great time, trust me. You really enjoyed yourself?
Yeah, yeah,
give them a big round of applause, the Atkinsons. So, Anthony, we're going to play in our big money final. Try and win yourself either £10,000 or £30,000 for your charity. Who are you going to play with?
I'm going to play big money with my dad, Paul.
Give it up for Paul and Anthony. Come on. After the break, we're going to be playing our big money final, and these guys are going to get a chance to win £30,000 for charity. We'll see you in a few. Welcome back. Before the break, we saw Anthony Cotton's family win the main game, which means it's now their chance at a shot for £30,000. Now, Anthony's backstage, so he can't hear or see us, which means Paul here is going to play first. So, let's play Big Money. Paul, I'm going to ask you 5 questions. If you can't think of an answer, just say pass and we'll come to it at the end. Your time starts when I finish the first question. We're going to give you 15 seconds. It's not a lot of time, but it can be done. Good luck, Paul. Are you feeling?
Confident.
Good luck, Paul.
Thank you.
Can I have 15 seconds on the clock? Name an animal that moves in a herd.
Cat.
Name something associated with Wimbledon.
Tennis.
Name someone you might see in a hospital.
A doctor.
Name something you wear on your legs.
Trousers.
Name a liquid that you put in your car.
Petrol.
Well done, Paul. Well done indeed. Paul the dice. Very good. Let's see how we got on. Now, we need 200 points. If we can get 200 points, it means we've got £10,000 for the Terence Higgins Trust. If, however, we get all top 5 answers, we're going to make that 10 grand, £30,000. Good luck. Name an animal that moves in a herd. You said... a cow. Our survey says... 30, well done. Name something associated with Wimbledon. You said... tennis. Our survey said... 44. Great start. Name someone you might see in a hospital. You said... a doctor. Our survey said... 34. 108. That's perfect. Halfway there already. Name something you wear on your legs. You said trousers. Our survey said 41. Man alive. Not people need answer to it this way. Name a liquid that you put in your car. You said petrol. Our survey said 35.
Well done, Paul. Well done indeed. Go back and join your family.
And let's welcome back Anthony Cotton. Good luck, Anthony.
Thank you very much.
Good luck. I can tell you, Paul scored 184 points.
That is amazing.
I know. So... I know. He was exceptionally confident and he did really well. 184, which means you need 16 for £10,000.
If I don't get 16, I'm really stupid.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to ask you the same five questions. If you can't think of an answer, just say pass.
Okay.
If we've got time, we'll come to it at the end.
Okay.
If you give me an answer that Paul's already given me, you'll hear this noise. I'll ask you to give me another answer. I'm going to give you 20 seconds.
Okay.
So you get 5 extra seconds because it's a little bit more difficult. Good luck, Anthony.
Okay.
Time starts when I finish the first question.
Okay.
Can remind the viewers at home of Paul's answers and can have 20 seconds on the clock. Good luck. Name an animal that moves in a herd.
A cow.
Another answer.
Sheep.
Name something associated with Wimbledon.
Tennis.
Another answer.
Cliff Richard.
Name something name something you might see in a hospital.
Doctor.
Another answer.
Surgeon.
Name something you wear on your legs.
Tights.
Name a liquid that you put in your car.
Petrol.
Another answer.
Diesel. Diesel.
Cliff Richard. Anthony, let's turn around and take a look at the board. Let's have your dad's answers on the board, please. There you go. Paul did really well, 184. Now, remember, we need 200 points for 10 grand. If you get all top five answers, we'll give you 3,000 pounds. It's your layman's terms, he's 30 grand. Good luck. Name an animal that moves in a herd. You said... sheep. Our survey said... yeah! Oh, come on! 199. And was cow the top answer?
Yes.
Well done. Well done, Paul. Well done, name something associated with Wimbledon. At first you said tennis, which, as you can see, Paul's already given us. Then you said...
So sorry. Was I supposed to say strawberries and cream, that kind of thing? Right, I get it now.
Then you said... Now, let's just hope that a member of Cliff Richard's fan club is involved in the survey, because you need 1 point or more for £10,000. Cliff Richard! Oh! Come on!
Cliff Richard, he's always at Wimbledon.
He is?
That's why I can't get a ticket, because he's got them all.
He's just not associated with it, that's all.
I'm so sorry.
It's all right, let's take a look. Now, is tennis the top answer?
Mock me.
Well done. We've got 2 top answers. We need 3 more for 30 grand. Name someone you might see in a hospital. You said a surgeon. 1 point or more for £10,000. Our survey said. No! Come on!
This is like torture.
Not the kind you
want. I was supposed to say patient, wasn't I? Patience.
Was doctor the top answer? No!
Oh, patient.
I can tell you the top answer was nurse.
No, I nearly said nurse.
Why couldn't
didn't
get
the, you? I couldn't get the word
said
out.
Cliff Richard instead. Unlucky. So we're looking for £10,000. Because doctor wasn't the top answer, we could no longer get 30 grand.
Okay.
So good luck.
Okay.
Name something you wear...
Oh, no!
Name something you wear on your legs. You said... tight. It's got to be worth a point or more for £10,000. Please. You said tight. For 10 grand, our survey said... Yeah!
Well done, Anthony.
Come down the camp, fans. Come and join me. Well done. Well done. The top answer is you wore your legs with trousers, and petrol was the top answer for the final question.
You just said nurses.
Yeah, you messed it up, but don't worry, you won £10,000! Well done, Anthony.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Give a big round of applause. They've done exceptionally well, and to their parents have been trusted. We really appreciate £10,000 and all the hard work that they do. Thank you to both our families. Join us next time when we play Family Fortunes. Good night. People, a range of everyday questions. This week, I've been in the ITV bar. No surprise. I know what you're thinking. But I asked 100 women the same question, and every single one of them slapped me in the face. The aim of the game is very simple. Two families have got to guess the top answers to the surveys we've carried out. Get them right, and they could win up to £30,000 for a charity of their choice. Get them wrong, and they'll hear this. I love that noise. Now, tonight's families are filled with excitement, hope and trepidation. In short, they're absolutely full of it. Now, are you ready to meet them, ladies and gentlemen?
Yes!
See if you can guess which bird rules the roost in this house.
Hi, Vernon. I'm her mum. Come on in.
Hi, I'm Peter, her stepdad.
Hi, I'm Nina, her sister. When she was a child, she'd keep us entertained with her impressions of Michael Jackson. It's supposed to be...
In 2007, she braved the jungle with a bunch of other celebrities, even though she's petrified of snakes. Woo!
Hi, I'm Rob. Oh, I forgot it. Sorry. Hi, I'm Rob. I'm her brother-in-law. And every year she brings out a new sexy calendar. Gotta do a poke.
It was nice having you over, Vernon.
Can't wait to see you on the hot tin.
Please welcome Gemma Atkinson! Hello, Gemma, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Didn't recognise you with your clothes on.
Oh, no, it's a change.
Gemma, where have you brought your family from?
From Bury and Haslingdon.
All right, Gemma, please introduce me to your family.
This is my mum, Sandra.
Hi, Sandra.
Hi, Vernon.
My stepdad, Peter.
Hi, Peter.
Hi, Vernon.
My sister, Nina.
Hi, Nina.
Hi, Vernon.
And my brother-in-law, Rob.
Hi, Rob.
Hi, Vernon.
Now, Rob, have you learnt to poke yet?
Oh, I'm trying.
Still going, Rob. Just give it one more go. Come on. Oh, there you go. There you are. Classic. Do you know which charity you play for tonight?
It's Penderbury Children's Hospital. They treated my nephew, Tyler, when he had meningitis, so...
Good. Good luck, the Atkinsons, tonight. Give them a big round of applause. Now then, you need two families to play Family Fortune, so see if you can guess who's the leader of this rowdy rabble.
I'm Enid, his mum.
I'm Paul, his dad.
Come in, we'll tell you all about him.
Hi, I'm Gemma, his oldest friend, and as a child, he used to do a lot of theatre, including playing a hobbit in The Hobbit.
Precious.
In 2007, he was named Best Actor for his performances in Coronation Street. I dedicate this award to all of my fans. You can see how he gets performances off, can't you? It's not me.
He's a huge fan of Shirley Bassey, and he knows every song by heart. Goldfinger, he's man, the man with the Midas touch. Hope you've enjoyed your visit, Vernon. See you soon. Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're in for a Northern Rumble tonight. Please welcome, from Coronation Street, Anthony Cotton! Hi, Anthony.
Hiya.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much for having me.
Not yet. Where have you brought your family from?
We've come from Berwick. Well, from Manchester.
Right, OK. Please, Anthony, introduce me to your family.
First of all, we've got my mum, Enid.
Hi, Enid.
Hello, Vernon.
my dad, Paul.
Hi, Paul.
Hi, Vernon.
This is my sister-in-law, the sister I never wanted. My sister-in-law, Michaela.
Hi, Michaela.
Hi, Vernon.
And my oldest best friend, Gemma.
Hi, Gemma.
Hi, Vernon.
Now, Anthony, tonight's all about charity. What charity are you playing for?
I'm playing for the fabulous Terence Higgins Trust.
Good luck. Good
Thank
luck.
Thank you very much.
Give them a big round of applause. The Cottons! Right, we've got our families and they're so switched on they could cause global warming. Gemma and Anthony, come and join me as we play Family Fortunes. Anthony, Gemma, Anthony, good luck. It's single money, every point's worth a pound. Surveyed 100 people, we're looking for the top 6 answers. Name someone you would trust to keep a secret. Anthony.
Your mum.
Your mum. You're saying your mum. Our survey says... Yes, your mum. It's up there, it's only the third most popular answer. Gemma, we're still looking for the top answer, what do you think?
Your best friend.
Good luck. You're saying your best friend. Our survey says... Yes. All right, as we go back to your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal. Sandra, name someone you would trust to keep a secret.
A sister.
Your sister. Well, let's see if it's up there. Good luck. Our survey says... It's not there. Unlucky, Sandra. Peter, what do you think?
Your mum. Oh, it's up.
It's gone now, Peter. Peter, are you in the room?
Your dad.
You're going for your dad. All right, Peter's saying his dad. Our survey says... It's not there. You've got one life left. Start conferring, Cotton family, because we might come over to you. You might get the chance to steal. Nina, what do you think?
Husband.
Your husband. Ooh. The pouter. You're saying your partner. Our survey says... Yes, well done. Get your family in the game. Now, Rob, over to you. What do you think?
A stranger.
Yeah, mate, you want to know a secret? You're saying a stranger. Our survey says... Oh, it's not them. What a shock!
Gemma, what do you think?
A priest.
A priest? Michaela?
Doctor.
Doctor, Paul? Not Dr. Paul, but Paul.
A work colleague.
A work colleague. Enid?
I was going to say a vicar. Is that different to a vicar,
priest? Different religion, but we'll have it all the same.
Doctor or teacher? I'm going to say a teacher. A teacher? Do you not think?
Doctor.
A teacher. Doctor. 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 A doctor. A doctor.
You're saying finally a doctor for the steal from the Atkinsons. Our survey says it's there! Well done. Well done. Well played. All right, let's take a look at those missing answers. The sixth most popular answer was a dog. A dog. A dog. Fourth most popular answer was vicar or priest. Well done, you said that. Congratulations. Now then, at the end of the first round, the Atkinsons have yet to score. But with 70 points, it's the Cottons. Now, don't worry, Atkinson family, there's no losers on this show. Apart from you, obviously. Join us after the break with more Family Fortunes. Welcome back to Family Fortunes. It's the Atkinson family versus the Cotton family. It's the man who makes underwear versus the girl who models it. Unfortunately, not tonight. Never mind. So, the Atkinsons have yet to score, but in the lead with 70 points, it's the Cottons. Sandra and Enid, come and join me. Let's play more Family Fortunes. Come on, Enid. Sandra, this is Enid. Enid, this is Sandra.
Hiya.
It's a shake hands. You did it wrong. Let's do that. Right, good luck, ladies. It's still single money. Every point's worth a point. One on by your buzzer, one on behind your back. Good, we're ready to go. Here goes. Name something you might do to make your partner smile. Sandra.
Take the clothes off.
Take your clothes off. You're starting with your bangle. My survey says it's there. Give him a flash. Sandra, unfortunately, that's not the top answer. Still looking for it. Enid, what do you think?
When I sing.
It makes your partner smile when you sing.
When I sing.
When you sing. You're saying when you sing, it makes your partner smile. Our survey says it's not there. Do you want to play or pass, Sandra? We're going to play. Okay, so Enid, go back to your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal. Sandra, go back. Peter, what do you think? Name something you might do to make your partner smile.
Tickle them.
Tickle them?
Yeah.
Our survey says... Yes, well done. Second most popular answer. Nina.
Buying presents.
You're saying buying presents. Our survey says... Yes, fourth most popular answer. We've got all three lives left. We're looking for three more answers. What do you think, Rob?
Weekend away.
Here we go. A weekend away. Oh, unlucky, Rob. Unlucky. Gemma, what do you think?
Tell them you love them.
Make them smile.
Hopefully it does.
You're saying tell them you love them. Our survey says... It's not there. Unlucky, Gemma. Sandra, you've got one life left. We need three answers. Cotton family, get ready. You might get the chance to steal. Good luck, Sandra. What do you think? Name something you might do to make your partner smile.
Send them flowers.
If it's up there, you're still on the board, you're still in control of the board. If it's not, Cottons will come in over to you. Good luck. You're saying send them flowers. Our survey says it's not there. Gemma, what do you think?
No, what I want to say, but...
What do you want to say?
Make love.
Maybe
not. I was going to say you love them, but we've had
we've had that.
That,
yeah. Paul?
Tell them a joke.
Tell them a joke. Enid?
Say I want a divorce.
I'll see what you think. You can have one of them or one of your own.
Thank you for that brilliant answer, Mum. I think we'd go with my dad. Tell them a joke.
Tell them a joke. If it makes your partner smile, you've stolen the board one more time from the Atkinson.